Number two, will this be the time? We won't see a Lulu, but that's okay. She's banned a lot. And there's a Rek'Sai ban for Jhin'Air. Not wanting to allow IM the chance to take that one. And of course, go to ogn.azubu.tv and vote for your favorite plays of the week. They have a very nicely laid out page to watch a lot of really cool plays from Champions Korea, so definitely worth doing.
Certainly something enjoyable to go do, yeah. And
it's
a cool place to see a lot of these highlight clips. So let's check it out. Lissandra will be banned this game.
All right.
By IM.
List to ban against Sunstar.
So we'll be Cassiopeia or Thresh last, and Maokai.
Huh.
Wow, I'm really surprised that has been one of IM's top champions this season. What are they going to first pick here?
Huh, I would imagine
potentially a Xerath.
I was going to say, do you feel obligated to ban the Xerath here and leave the Cassiopeia open? I'd feel like that'd be a bit safer than leaving the Xerath open.
I think you just ban Thresh. You don't want Tucson having that champion. GBM can play the RE into
All
it.
Right.
They're going to take out LeBlanc as well.
Okay. So what is IM going to take? You know, they have that choice.
Xerath.
Between Xerath and Thresh. And I think you got to keep Xerath away from GBM.
They have to take it first.
Yeah. They're kind of obligated in this case. And Jhin'Air knows this. They've got a plan.
Now, to be fair to Incredible Miracle, they have, in fact, beaten Jhin'Air while first picking Xerath in their last meeting.
That is true.
So this is a strategy that has worked for them previously. Frozen is a very good Xerath player.
However, would you say that was a bit of an odd circumstance? It was a bit of an aberration, per se. Despite how good Frozen is, most good teams should have an answer to this.
And the answer is probably just going to be Rumble, and then maybe Ezreal to chunk him out in the back line. The Rumble, no surprise. Jarvan as well.
Get ready to not have Flash, Frozen.
They have a contingency plan, obviously, for this happening.
See, here's what they do. They shift Xerath into the support role, and then they find a different counter pick.
I think
that's what you do. That's what I do.
I think it's probably going to be a mid-Ezreal game here from GBM. We've seen a lot of Jhin'Air playing Rumble Xerath or Rumble Ezreal to chunk out the back line. They have this opportunity to really try and punish this immobile Xerath pickup. And Corki, I think a really good choice here.
Oh, really?
Graves is fine, too.
I was going to say, what about a TF? Oh, and there we go. I think the TF would be a great answer. I'd love to see GBM play it.
Absolutely. TF Graves, another way that you can get into that back line.
Oh, man.
And because what IM was trying to do here was take away the Corki to prevent the Corki Ezreal pick coming out, which could have been interesting for sure in terms of Jhin'Air's composition. But TF, they don't have to pick it now. They can just go ahead and wait for it.
True.
And I don't think you take the TF immediately when you have the red side last pick.
Well, they've already got their support. I mean, does it really matter a whole lot if you know that Xerath is going mid?
I think you just take Annie here, just to make sure that you're not going to get super punished on the Twisted Fate, depending on the composition.
Yeah.
Annie Graves, really strong kill pressure at 6.
Yeah. True enough.
I think they take Sivir here, if you're IM.
Then you just go mid Corki, you're saying?
Oh, yeah. No, never mind. I think that Corki pick
supports Xerath.
Supports Xerath.
Top Janna. We got this. All right, so Lee Sin
the Sivir
in the top lane.
The Sivir may have been better than that Corki. I do understand why they would prioritize that Corki, seeing what Jhin'Air was trying to do and maybe anticipating that Ezreal. So we do see the Irelia pickup, actually, for Lilac. I think Lilac will do better on this champion. I'm just not feeling these caster tops for Lilac. He continues to underperform on them.
Oh boy, I don't know. If he picks that Katarina, that puts a lot of pressure on my Bowtie pick for GBM this game. My Bowtie pick is 1-0 so far.
There we go.
Ahri works fine too. Ahri Twisted Fate. Whatevs. I suppose that TF might be a little bit more vulnerable to Irelia.
Yes.
The back lines. I like the Ahri a little bit more here. Bit safer.
Also, the Janna. I think that's the main concern because you TF and then Janna Monsoons, and then you can't get back in very easily. Meanwhile, with Ahri, you get Monsooned out, and you could just use another charge of Spirit Rush to get right back in the mix. So I think the Ahri better here, and that will be locked in.
Indeed it will. And so Jhin'Air is like, all right, we know you're going to take that Xerath, and we are prepared to own you for it.
Jhin'Air running this really all-in composition, trying to punish Frozen, not really worried about the rest of Incredible Miracle, and why would they be? Lilac didn't have a great game last time. Frozen, obviously the major carry threat on this team.
Yeah, I think this one's going to be...
shut him down and see what you could do. Lilac, in the late game, may have some issues on Aurelia, and we've seen how strong Trace's Rumble is so far this season.
I think this is going to be a pretty fun game to watch with the composition that Jhinair has put together. It's going to be pretty action-packed.
I don't know how Frozen's going to stay alive. You have tons of these ults that can hit the back line. Plus, you have to deal with a Jarvan, Annie, and Ahri just on top of you.
Yeah. You ever notice how happy Graves looks in his portrait? Look at that. He just looks so joyful.
That's what happens when you get to shoot a giant shotgun, though. If I got to shoot Graves' shotgun, I would be that happy.
Do you ever do, like, skeet shooting and stuff like that?
It is fun, isn't it?
It
is super fun.
I grew up in Wisconsin, Minnesota. Of course I've done it.
I grew up in the Boy Scouts. Of course I did.
Well, there you go. Yeah.
In Colorado.
That's right. As long as you practice proper firearm safety, of course.
Correct.
Yes. So, in light of that, Jhinair versus IM. IM, they need a 2-0 to keep their playoff dreams alive. Can they do it? It's do or die. Let's get in the game and find out. Welcome to Summoner's Rift. I am versus the Jhinair Green Wings. I am fans clearly not giving up yet. But has this Xerath first pick kind of come back to haunt them? But again, you know, as we see this pause, they were sort of put in a corner, right? Where you have to take the Xerath away from GBM, but then that gives Jhinair this chance to punish it so hard, and it looks like they really did.
Yep. And, I mean, they saw this same priority on the Xerath in their last match. They're definitely taking what they've learned and applying it to this game. Now, with Aurelia and Corki, they will have a really strong Trinity Force power spike should they choose to use it.
Now, am I remembering this right, that Frozen's blind pick Xerath game against Jhinair in the first round was like our first blind pick Xerath win of the season?
No, GBM has done it as well.
Did he do it before Frozen?
Yeah.
But was it still at a time where we didn't know that Frozen was as good on Xerath as he was?
Yes.
I think that was a bit of a surprise.
Yeah. But he performed well in that game. It's the Houndstooth pattern, though. I'm not sure what you're talking about, spaceships.
Dude, I don't know. I see that. I see that, and I see Space Invader spaceships. You see it, and you're like, oh, I'm Mr. Fashion. That's obviously a Houndstooth pattern. Oh.
Pretty sure most people know what Houndstooth is.
As Monty sips his fine Cavassier with his pinky up. Oh, of course.
Pretty sure.
Oh, whoops. Well, at least you've got a sick shirt, dude. Don't worry about it. That's right.
Oh, poor fan. Not being here on the day to see CJ Antis.
You got to really be careful, though, because some days it's a great day to see CJ Antis. Some days it's a little bit, you know, not as great.
Okay, I'm pretty sure he's happy he missed the CJ loss to mid-Scion double Banner of Command from the GE Tigers on Saturday.
That was not a good day, that's right.
It was a great day for me. I enjoyed seeing that very much. But.
See, now more than anything, we need a time machine so that fans like him can go back to when, like, CJ Frost was, like, godly and Mad Life was just, like, the king of the world. Meanwhile, action right after this pause here. Tucson getting poked out a little bit. Annie with that long auto-attack range is pretty great. So, will we see a bit of a lane swap, you think, coming in from either one of these teams?
Doesn't seem like Trace wants to do one. He does have Cloth 5 as a start, and that would be pretty bad in a lane up against the Janna and Corki, considering he would be taking a lot of magic damage poke from Corki.
Right.
So, Jhinair not going to want that outcome. Otherwise, we just see a pretty standard start right here. Ares will be going for these Krugs, his friends Tucson and Sunstar. And
D's Krugs.
D's Krugs.
Yep. Hextech Janna, the skin of choice for Korean supports, in case you didn't know that.
Is that your Janna skin of choice?
I usually use Weatherwoman.
They're going to give the... Look at that. So early advantage. Sunstar and Tucson going to take the small Krug right there. But whole Gromp going over to Jhin Air, and Lee Sin will move into the red buff instead. So interesting start, but edge to Jhin Air. We saw them with that advantage last game. Violet NXT working quite well, and they're going to hit a really fast level two. IM doesn't know that this is going to be the case, so they may try and bait this. Oh, they know now.
Oh, there we go. Oh. A lot of damage. Sansar getting poked up pretty heavily.
Again, two games in a row.
Yep.
Jhin Air being tricky in terms of how much experience they have, and they did a good job of baiting that in. You'll notice that they didn't telegraph that. They walked right back in the lane before they hit two. Hmm. And now Sansar taking a massive chunk.
He's realized that he took the wrong Krug. You never want to take the wrong Krug.
He took the left Krug, so not the right Krug, you know.
That's true. it never even more true now, right? You don't take the left Krug, you take the right
Krug. You always want to take the right Krug.
That's right. It's the ancient Krug. Of course you want that one. It's older, therefore, you know, wiser and filled with more experience, obviously.
And if you kill it, you absorb its powers.
That's right. You have to eat its heart. Stony Krug heart. Did I take that too far? Nah. That's okay.
Heart eating is a proud Aztec tradition.
That's true. You know, I always thought, like in Thanksgiving, like turkey hearts were really good.
Did you gain the power of the turkey, though?
Well, if the power of the turkey is to, like, sleep a lot afterwards, then yes, I totally gained the power of the turkey. Yep. I would also go gobble gobble at certain points tonight afterwards. Did happen. I'm certainly picking the wrong animal spirit to consume, aren't I?
The turkey is your spirit animal? Is that what I'm learning?
I guess so. I don't know. Didn't Ben Franklin want that to be like the national bird of the U.S. or something?
Yeah. You gained the mighty powers of the flightless bird.
Would that mean we'd have to eat bald eagles then on Thanksgiving? That'd be way harder to like farm and catch than turkeys. That's I think, the real reason that the bald eagles are a national bird in the U.S., you know? Because they're like, oh, man, it's so much work to like catch and eat a bald eagle. But turkeys, they're just right on the ground. Yeah, they can fly a little bit, but...
Also vastly less majestic.
Yeah, totally. And so much more useful, you know?
It's a practical bird.
Yeah, exactly. The working man's bird. Although if you were like in ancient London, it'd be the pigeon, I suppose. You'll eat a lot of those back today, I think.
Oh man, Sansar continuing to get poked really hard in this lane situation, starting to fall behind in terms of CS, and
it's
exactly what Jhin Air wants. Bully this Corki early with the Graves, having that very good level 2 timing, and IM again a little bit behind. To Jhin Air's credit, they have been quite tricky this game. You wouldn't normally get the Gromp when you have a Jarvan in the jungle. So I like Jhin Air. They are playing very deceptively in the 2v2 here today.
Continuing to dominate that early game. Ares coming in. They're going to try to make a plan to chase.
Chaser's
here. Chaser's right
there.
They're
baiting it.
Ares backing away, hanging her out there. He doesn't get the knockup, though. Ares barely low. They need to be careful. This fight's going to be extended. Lilac a little bit low as well. There's the safeguard. Ares should not have come back in. Had to flash. And will they get the flash out of Lilac? A little bit more damage. Oh, the double kill for Trace. And he gets away clean. Oh, man, that could not have been any worse.
Even though Chaser was just a little bit out of range right there, they turned it around so beautifully with that bait. Oh, that is just a brutal gank right there. XD now harassing Frozen in the mid lane also.
Dude, wow, forget Pigeon and Turkey and Bald Eagle. Trace likes to cook his Lee Sin and Aurelia, apparently.
Man, and you know, this isn't even a bad gank. They see Trace is overheated. He doesn't have any cooldowns anymore, so why not go for him? They get the stun right there. And then, I'm not really sure why Chaser flashed.
That was interesting.
I think he was trying to flash knockup and then messed it up.
Ah, okay.
But, yeah, this is...
One, two.
Disgusting.
Yeah.
Chaser with a Dragon Lance just in case. Well, Trace has a massive advantage now. You can see already Arm Guard and an Anthem.
Tucson is right there. Yeah, that's right. Trace may have made a bit of a mistake here. There's the exhaust. He's going to go down. Will he get a chance to flash? He's not even going to try.
He already flashed.
He's walking away. He already did flash. Here comes Chaser. Chaser slowed down with that Chilling Smite. Will he make it out now? He has no summoners, and he's going to give his life to keep that top laner alive. I think a fairly decent trade.
Oh, man. Well, actually, it was better for Trace to die right there because he had TP up. Yeah, he had TP up, and Lilac has his down, so he could have immediately just TP'd to the top side like this.
Or would it have been more gold, though? Oh, Equalizer used to try to clear that wave. The dive comes in, and Trace is going to go down, too. Uh-oh. Whoops. I am doing a good job of coming back and getting their own kills here in the top lane.
Yeah.
You know, meanwhile, Sunstar's done a pretty good job of farming down in bot lane. He's largely caught up in CS, too.
And when you play against IM, you have to be aware that Tucson will walk into the top side. He's done it on numerous occasions to turn things around. So Trace really overplaying himself right there, had the advantage and kind of threw it away. Pretty off of a really great gank and a really great gank from Jhinair. They just get too cocky, play sloppy, and then give up two kills right off the bat. So any advantage that they have, and a flush down the toilet. Sunstar also catching up in terms of CS because XD was motioning up toward the mid and the top side.
Well, that brings this game back to pretty much even at this point.
Pilot going to be going for the Brutalizer first, so he really wants this to be a lane bully here.
Yeah. Well, you notice as soon as XD shows back up, suddenly it's another 10 CS lead for Pilot. So as long as they can keep this 2v2 around, they can punish Sunstar pretty heavily, it seems like.
Yeah, they need to get a gank off, though. They are about to hit 6 on both the AD and support, and they have this Brutalizer, so they have to snowball it into something. Otherwise, won't be anywhere near as effective as a Trinity Force in the mid-game for Sunstar.
Yep. They have gotten a good amount of damage onto that turret, at least, so far. GBM is doing just fine in the mid lane. Even on CS.
Yep, and this is where the kill pressure really starts for Jhinair. Chaser is 6.
Oh, Equalizer goes down. Lilac pops that ultimate. A lot of it dodged by Trace.
Chaser's
here.
Here
we go. Yeah, Cataclysm used. There's a knockup on Ares. A little bit of trouble. Nice. GBM comes in for that kill. Spirit rushes over to get the.
They can still follow this up.
Yeah, get the rebound on the Orb of Deception, rather. There's a charm onto Lilac just out of nowhere, man. Easy kill. They're going to try to give it to Chase, though. Oh, he misses the harpoon. Come on, guys. Come
just
on.
Just a matter of time.
Come on. It's a little bit lazy. Okay. Yep. Oh. Yep. Equilibrium strike. And they're like, all right, come on. There we go. Trace finally picks that one up.
Silly Aurelia. Yeah.
I know.
Actually, Jhinair could have been a little bit more decisive, especially after they got the kill on Elise. They saw Frozen still hanging out in the mid lane.
Yep.
So under those conditions, we could have seen a little bit more from GBM. But they still pick up a couple of kills in top. Good roam from GBM after pushing up the turret. Cost him a bit of CS, but he'll be happy with kill and assist.
Yeah. Getting kills on to people who should be getting kills on Jhinair as well, too. 3 onto the top laner, 1 to the mid laner. Pilot ahead in CS again. Just a bit. And so Frozen now, going for that, going for his Merenomicon, did I?
Yep.
Okay, there we go. For some reason, I couldn't remember the name of that item for some reason. It's weird. But that's what he's going for. But
GBM actually starting out with an Evil Slayer Lara Drod.
I was going to say, yeah, he's compared to what GBM's bought, that's going to be quite the lopsided damage coming out of the mid laners right now.
GBM going for that early power spike, probably just had 1600 when he went back and wanted to make the most of it.
Dude.
But his wave clear is not going to be awesome without very much mana regeneration.
What do you think about rushing Luden's Echo on Ahri? You could get, theoretically, some decent little AoE off of the proc, and not to mention the movement speed helps Ahri out.
Yeah, it's just, it's not a great item overall.
Mm.
Just in
terms,
if you compare it to Rabadon's Death Cap.
Oh, Flash Shivers on the Sunstar. Chaser's right there. The heal, not enough, and Tucson needs to get out of there. They're just going to leave him. Teleport canceled by Trace. No need to come down.
Yeah, teleport canceled after Lilac canceled his. So
yep.
Just making sure they would have that presence considering they blew all of their ults right away.
Yeah.
And now they have control over that dragon. They're going to be going for it. And Luden's Echo, it's just, it's so hard to say that it's better than Death Cap or the Zhonya's Hourglass.
Would you go for a fast Death Cap, though, on the Ahri? I would imagine it would have to be Zhonya's, but then why not start with Armguard, you know?
Because he has
get it stacking faster.
Well, Because the thing about Armguard is that if you just buy it and immediately turn it into Sonya's, then you don't have to stack it. There's no stacking bonus. So having he just wants the damage right now. This is his attempt to roam and do as much damage as possible, even if it does cost him some CS and some wave clear right here. And probably, like I said, he just had 1,600 gold and wanted to create a power spike for himself in terms of his ability to all in and put pressure on this Xerath. But now that Cataclysm is down, that will be a little bit harder for Chaser to do.
Yep. Oh, GBM. Oh, well, that's interesting. All right. Well, an auto. That was actually a very brave move by Tucson with nobody really around. I mean, Frozen was coming up the lane, but GBM with that needlessly large rod could have probably blown him up pretty quickly.
Yeah, now actually that caused Chaser to have to cover the mid wave just to not take a lot of damage onto his turret.
Yeah. Oh, GBM looks like he might be going for a Mirella Namakan after that needlessly large rod.
Yeah, I think he realizes that he's got to get some sort of mana boost right now.
It's like, sorry, dude, DFG doesn't exist anymore. Equalizer use, and that turret is still going to take a little bit of damage, but not a ton.
It is understandable why he would get it, though. Chaser did decide to gank the bottom lane, but Xerath was super vulnerable against early needlessly large rod like that.
True.
He doesn't have heal or anything, so one good all-in from Chaser by blowing his flash and then hitting him with Cataclysm would have meant a dead Xerath. So it did put a lot more kill pressure on the mid lane, and he didn't lose his tower for it or anything like that. So.
I suppose that is true.
Definitely not the worst thing in the world if you just happen to have that 1,600 gold right away. And here we go. Gank squad.
Yeah, they've got the wards taken out. Gonna wait off on the gank for a little bit then. All right. So, Jhenair, not with a ton of opportunities to gank lanes at the moment. So, might as well pull back, make sure you have decent vision, and just kind of farm up, wait for the next dragon, maybe wait for an opportunity in mid.
Yeah, they don't have the best siege this game. They have to make picks and fight around Dragon and Baron. So that's what they're going to be looking to do. They can dive very effectively. They get enough of a lead. But it's mostly going to be just about spreading out around Dragon, controlling that vision, and then blowing whoever walks into a brush up or attempting to all in the back line from Incredible Miracle. So they have to be patient.
I mean, that is a nice thing if you have this sort of low siege composition where if you've got Graves, you can still toss his ult in the back line and do a lot of damage. Whereas if it's a Sivir, like we've seen in the past, you kind of just have to sit back and wait for them to come to you a bit.
Yeah, so. Or just use your ult to get your front line in there and auto-attack their front line.
Right.
But especially with the Brutalizer first, that's going to be hitting really hard. Brutalizer BF really ramping up Graves' abilities. And that ward is not going to see XD and Chaser coming into lane.
Yep. They can't quite get to the brush yet, it looks like. Ares is there for a possible counter gank.
This is a good move on the map by XD.
Yep. Oh. Got it back off. Lilac checking.
I love this vision game that we're seeing. So fun.
Yeah. They're not going to get a chance. They're going to try to come down. Oh, they walk right through the ward. Whoops. All right, and Ares immediately leaves. He's like, nope.
Damn, that was getting really entertaining for a second.
Yeah, and there's a ward right there, too.
They could just all in it anyway.
I think they might try. There we go. That's a two-man Timber stun. They set themselves up so well for that, but here comes Tucson. Can't quite heal with the ult enough, but the ult comes in. Xerath manages to help Lilac pick one up. Frozen able to be in range of that ultimate, but here's GBM coming from behind. They're going to go towards the turret. Trace getting locked up for the moment. Is GBM going to come up? XD, no stun loaded up at the moment, but he's still got that damage. The Q coming in. Wow. Goodbye, Tucson. A kill for GBM. Lilac in big trouble now. That's going to be another one for Gank by Mom. A double kill now on that Ahri. And even though Frozen came up to support, got that kill onto Chaser, it was so easy for GBM just to walk right up behind him.
I am really overcommitted to that. Yeah. As soon as you trade that one for one, you just got to accept it, especially with IM with the ultimate down. You know GBM's going to be walking up there. You don't see him in the mid lane. He followed Xerath all the way up to the top side of the map.
Now, with that all in, too, I believe it was either Ares safeguarded over or Lilac flash, but somehow they got next to each other. And as an Annie player, I'm like, oh, well, that's going to be really easy for Timbers to stun, and sure enough, it was a big two-man stun, and they really just kind of handed that one to Jhenair on a silver platter.
Yeah, good flash, or good engage there for XD. He didn't even have to use flash, actually, or to set it up, but yeah, it was Ares safeguarding on top of Lilac.
Yeah.
That sort of caused that scenario, and the follow-up equalizer
was totally
to help Trace pick up the kill. Totally GBM really starting to get rolling right now.
It's totally an all-chat thanks, bro moment. Not that I would ever be that bad man.
No, you say far worse things.
Monitors explode at the level of my toxicity. Like System of a Down only wishes they could write a song that could describe it.
Toxicity of our server.
That's right. It was about League of Legends. Who knew?
System of a Down asking the important questions. How do you own disorder?
That's
deep
true.
Philosophers that they are.
Toxicity of our city.
Of our servers.
Of our servers. Our city servers. It's Matrix, yo. Yep. There's that report that came out where apparently it was like only 10% of League players were considered good-mannered, whereas like half of the others were neutral and the other half were toxic. Like, oh, okay. Sounds about right. 1 in 10? Yeah, okay.
It's amazing what
sounds
happens
right.
when you get a bunch of teenagers together with the anonymity of the internet.
I know. I can't believe it.
I'm really surprised.
I'm shocked. I did not expect that. Huh. We need to maybe have little clips of Mr. Rogers during the loading screen. I think that would solve a lot.
It's too late for that.
No, you
they
can't.
They needed the Mr. Rogers like 10 years ago, though.
No, man. Mr. Rogers is good for any age, dude. You can't watch Mr. Rogers for 5 minutes and then not be really nice for the rest of the day. It's true. Riot needs to, like, partner with PBS.
That's right. Whenever you get reported in a game, it forces you to watch Mr. Rogers for 5 minutes before you could actually queue up again.
Oh, that would be great. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Yep. If you get banned, it's just like a screen of him shaking his head, sadly.
Okay, this is really dangerous for IM.
Yeah.
Ares is here.
Going to get flanked. There's a charm onto Ares. No follow-up at the moment. Teleport
go.
Coming down from
good
Jhin'Air.
Port. Really good port from Trace.
Yep, going to help finish off that dragon, and they will be able to do that. Stun onto Ares to make sure there's no steal, and Pilot just destroys him with the collateral damage. Ooh, boy.
Pretty much no way IM could actually contest that.
Yeah.
They did get a top tower due to Lilac's pressure with the Sheen, but with a teleport like that, with Jhin'Air all on one side, and you have the... Basically, IM's choice was, are we going to engage onto them? And they didn't even really get a chance. Trace just drops the Equalizer. Pilot pops his collateral damage, and that is the end of Ares' life right there. XD not even having to put down the Tippers.
Yep. Save that one. Even though Tibbers is on basically zero cooldown, which is great. Well, Trace will just push his bot lane up for the moment. And we're back to kind of another little passive moment for Jhin'Air. And yeah, this is what they do so well. They, you know, aside from a couple moments here and there in the later stages of the game, they generally are pretty good about just waiting these things out and playing it safely.
Well, here we go for IM. They've got their double Trinity Force right now. This is where they have to do something.
Yeah, they've got to try it.
Also, no dragon for Jhin'Air to fight around, so they do have an ability to split push at the moment and try and take some extra turrets down that way. But they're at a deficit. It will be hard, and Jhin'Air...
Wow, easy turret up here. There's going to be no stopping Jhin'Air.
Really surprised. No defense.
Will they trade bot lane for this? Maybe. I don't know. That's a lot of health on that.
Trace can drop Equalizer anytime he wants.
He is waiting for it. Okay. Yep, there it is. Okay, just waiting for the next wave, it looked like.
Building his heat up a little bit right there.
Yep. A little bit more damage onto Sunstar, and so they can't trade turrets now. Frozen still stuck under his in mid. Ares clearing out a few of these wards in their jungle, but Jhin'Air still with pretty good vision overall. And it just doesn't seem like IM's going to really get the opportunity to put any of this sieging into practice, you know?
Nope. Probably not, but they have to at least try a 4-1 right now with Aurelia and then have everyone else with the poke they have.
Yeah. I mean, Aurelia
make some sort of move, but Jhin'Air has some decent wave clear on this team.
Yeah.
And they have a very threatening all-in that can really go off at any time. I just think Jhin'Air had the perfect pick ban strategy up against Incredible Miracle for what they selected in this game. It's so hard for IM to do anything.
It seems really smart of Jhin Air right now, too, with no Dragon to worry about. They just shift their dual lane up in the top to get a little bit more control over Baron. And, you know, that still puts Lilac against Trace in the bot lane, which isn't too threatening for Trace right now.
No, and you can just clear out waves with the Equalizer. You can be perfectly patient right now as he starts to build up into some of these bigger items.
Makes a lot of sense.
And without Corki in the mid lane with Xerath, there's just no sieging. They have to work on getting this mid lane turret down. That should be their main focus, yet they continue to send Zonstar into the side lanes.
Oh boy. Whoa. Okay then.
A single tortured scream
erupts
from the twisted corpse.
That's right. That was one of the saddest things I've ever seen in my life. Oh man, I'm going to have nightmares about that. Jeez. Mid lane turret in a lot of trouble. Jhin Air has the flank. They've got the dive if they wanted to. I don't think IM wants to give him that one. GBM getting a bit poked, but the turret does go down. Man, the tortured cry of Janna is just utterly blown up.
Did get a QSS, so we see that. We've seen the QSS before in some of these hard engage compositions.
It's not going to help if you
from
get
Gorilla,
like that.
From Gorilla, the GE Tigers. I think it's a good buy.
It is.
Because you can always, the reasoning behind it, if you haven't seen Gorilla do this, is if you're the one who is CC'd, at least you can monsoon everybody out and try and save your team in that situation.
Yeah.
Because you getting shut down and not being able to use monsoon against a really hard engage composition usually means that everyone else is dead as well. So at first glance, it seems rather selfish, but it can actually, if you can blow all their cooldowns for nothing, then it actually becomes hugely advantageous on Janna.
Sure, and it gives you more of a chance to live long enough to ult yourself, so that would help. Well, Jhin Air continuing to be pretty dominant in game number two. A little over a minute until Dragon comes up again, and they'll be looking to get some vision down before that happens.
Yeah, it may take them a while to close, depending, but after the next Dragon, they should be able to successfully bait a Baron, or even do it. I mean, if you look right now, they have an early Liandry's, so they will be doing a lot of burn damage to the Baron. They could probably take it relatively quickly.
Yeah, I mean, Jhin Air does lack in siege, per se, but they have ways to really punish people that step too far out of line with the charm and things like that. Lilac fighting Trace, actually doing a lot of damage. Is this going to be a 1v1? Lilac, there's a flash from Trace. There's the Equalizer to slow him down. The Xerath ultimate comes in. Dodge, dodge, dodge! And Trace not taking enough damage on that third one, and he will live.
Pretty good safety dance right there.
No kidding.
And Lilac used that Equilibrium Strike really early, so he only got the stun.
Yep.
Or the slow instead of the stun. Chaser will be harassing Ares a bit. But they made a play in the top side. No Xerath ultimate now, no Equalizer, and no Transcendent Blades for this Dragon fight. Trace is able just to heal up with the home guards and get back into lane. Looks like he's going to be building more tankiness next, heading into a Rylai's.
Perhaps. He's got that arm guard too. Do you think he might just go ahead and finish Zhonya's as well? Instead, I should say.
Well, he built arm guard into Amp Tome
and
Belt, so probably not, but maybe.
Yeah. No, you're probably right.
Dragon's live. Good siege from IM. Now this is what they should be doing in this situation, and they're able to push out into mid right now. They got some good pressure, so nice 4-1 from IM, finally realizing that they have this power spike and they can use it in spite of a 5k gold deficit. This is nicely done by Incredible Miracle.
Everybody in the mid lane right now, except for Trace. Still up in top lane, but he can teleport down when he wants to. Jhin Air may just have to give up this turret.
Yeah, they may have to give up the dragon too, because they don't have adequate vision at the moment.
Well, you saw Chaser recall for just a moment, so they're kind of thinking about it. Sunstar's in a ward right now. That's a little bit dangerous. There we go, they're going to clear it out. And Jhin Air has a little bit of vision, actually, by the dragon. They've got the Riftsculler right now, and they've got a ward in the pit, too. So it's not the safest it could be for IM. Yeah, and they can clear these lanes so easily, so IM really can't push mid all that hard. Oh, Q onto GBM.
Wow, they weren't able to clear the pink, though. You can see the threat of that crowd control is so serious that they backed off before they could even get the final hit. They just want to poke. Really nicely done. IM is playing
Oh, boy.
Very well.
There it is. The ult coming in. Can they get him? The flash from XD. That's going to prevent a big Tibber is engaged. XC is so low that it's going to be tough for him to get into a fight now.
This is really well played by IM, actually. This whole Baron Dance, this whole scenario.
Yeah.
Using that pressure in the top side, the 4-1, realizing what they needed to do, but there's an equalizer.
Yeah, the Dragon does go over to IM, but here comes Generic. Can they do anything? GBM already with one kill. Trace roasting Lilac. That's a lot of damage onto him as well. Chaser having to come the long way around the Baron Pit, but it's okay because it's already a double for Pilot. Valkyrie over the wall. Looks like the two carriers will escape. Meanwhile, a turret goes down in favor of IM.
That was a
in bot lane.
4v5. I mean,
yeah,
XC not even there, but crucially, the Monsoon was really misplayed by
Tuesday.
Oh,
it's a Baron.
Yeah, it's a Baron.
Yep.
The Monsoon really didn't do anything at all to help them out because Chaser didn't decide to go into the back line. He just EQ'd and ulted Ares instead to blow him up immediately on top of the Equalizer. And that was well played from Jhin Air, but you can see that lead coming into effect. And it's a bummer because if IM wasn't at such a deficit, they played that really well regardless. So
yeah.
Take a look at this right now. This is a 4v5. So Ares is down. Now watch Tucson's Monsoon. It's a really bad Monsoon. Because they just turn immediately onto Lilac. Doesn't really affect them at all. Frozen already chunked out as well. Great team fighting from Jhin Air to play around the Monsoon. And they mind-gamed a little bit. Tucson thinking that GBM was going to come in with the Spirit Rush instead. Changes mind.
And just really
baits it out.
Really heads up from Jhin Air as well, too, to not try to chase that beyond the Baron bit. They saw Flash's user like, all right, we don't need to use our summoners. We can just go take Baron.
Yep.
Not bad. And by not bad, I mean really good.
Mara's had some pretty good play tonight. And I really do think they had the right idea there as they took that dragon.
Oh, yeah.
They were just falling so far behind already. And Jhin Air proving that they have a superior team fight and winning that pretty decisively in a 4v5. Imagine if they had Annie. Probably would have just been a clean ace.
Yeah, when you add in that stun from Tibbers, not many people are going to escape that.
Trace's Rumble is so good. I mean, we've seen him get a Zubu Super Plays for his Rumble play before.
Yep, that's right.
Really scary.
Had many great plays. His super play was a really amazing sort of block with Zonias and Flame Spitter and Baron Pit.
Yeah, it was really, really nicely done. And the super minions, even this rather poor split pushing team, should be able to get, sieging team, should be able to get something done.
Yeah.
Pilot taking a lot of hits, though.
Well, they got about half of that turret's health taken away.
Yes, Chaser. Now is the time to do their raids instead of pushing
Raptors.
Or Raptors, whatever. I've been around the league for too long.
I see.
They only recently became Raptors. I spent like 5 years of them being raids.
That is true. I'll give you that. Actually, what about the whites, though? They've already been forgotten. Around for such a short time, now they're just Grumps.
I like the Grump better.
I do too.
I never really liked the white.
Well, the white was just like a bigger raid, you know? That's all it was. And it was just a jungle monster, mostly known for getting kills for Samsung. Onto embarrass the junglers on the other side. There goes the turret. Jhin Air taking that one down. 4 turrets to 3. They've got that nice lead, and again, they can just sit back, play it safely, keep these lanes pushing up. Trace will take care of top now. Righteous Glory finished on XD for a little while now.
Is he going for the talisman next? He
oh,
is.
Oh, yes. That's right.
It's the medallion.
Yep. Don't necessarily need the Frost Queen's Claim or anything like that when you're playing a champion like Annie. The slow is not anywhere near as good as having that extra engage to help you land those sweet, sweet Tibber stuns.
Only the sweetest of Tibber stuns.
Oh, yes. So, at this point.
No more Baron buff?
No.
Pretty
That's exactly what I was going to say, thank you.
Pretty bad sieging team. So it's time to wander around the jungle, Doa.
I mean, we saw this happen in their match last week against Najin as
do.
Well. Yeah, and I feel like they're better equipped this time than they were then because then they had like a Sivir comp and they really couldn't siege with that. At least with this, you have ways to pull people out of the back line with Charm to do damage in the back line with Equalizer and with collateral damage.
Yeah, but you're against Corki Xerath. You're going to eat like so much both. And nobody's really tanky on your team. And we saw how much damage Grave took, even with a Bloodthirster, to try and get that down. Bloodthirster and Baron buff.
Could be worse.
Could be. Could be playing Twitch.
Could be playing Quinn. Yep. Apparently they're buffing her in 5.6, though.
Oh, boy.
Quinn meta incoming. Look out.
Yeah, Jhenair, they really, really can't do anything right now. They have to just get some wards down, try and starve out their jungle, push the waves and chip towers as best they can while they wait for this next dragon, and hope that IM fights them if they want to take an objective. It's one of those games, though, where Jhenair pretty much has this 1-1, but they actually are not going to be able to close for quite some time, more than likely.
Yeah.
And it's not their fault. It's just how the composition works versus Xerath, Corki, and all the wave clear that IM has and the ways to punish with poke.
You know, so you can kind of, like, talk about teams' different strategies as sort of different car-oriented things, I think, where some games are like a drag race, some are like, off-road. But Jhenair is kind of like a very relaxing Sunday afternoon drive through the countryside, you know? Just take your time, flash Tibbers, you know, once in a while, throw down the Equalizer, and then you go in and kill your opponents. Yep, pretty much like it's happening this fight. A little bit of damage coming in, though, from Frozen. It's all Jhenair, though. See? Flash Charm. Ooh, didn't quite connect. Chaser gets a kill anywhere in Tucson. So, like I said, a relaxing Sunday country drive.
Yep. Really? That's how you would talk about an all-in pick composition like this, though?
My point was illustrated perfectly just now, and no one will ever contest my
What a great analogy.
On that. Thank you. Only the best. Yeah. There you go. Best analogy KR. Dragon's up. It's going to be dragon number 3 for Jhenair. They had to give one up. They've now gotten 7 out of the last 8 dragons in this series. Frozen will get a blue buff.
Are you ready to wait for the Baron fight that's coming up in a minute?
I am.
You bet
I'm ready. You bet I'm ready. See, that moment was like you're on your pleasant country drive and like one of the neighbor's farm dogs like runs in the road and you have to like swerve to avoid it, but you do. And the dog's fine and you're fine. You know, you slide a little bit around on the gravel, but then you just keep going. And you're like, oh goodness, that was a bit exciting, wasn't it, dear? Like, oh yes.
Are you gonna power slide on the gravel for the Baron buff?
Oh yeah.
Wow, using the
Too Fast, Too Furious.
Righteous Glory right there to control the Scuttler. It's actually a good use of that.
Why not? I mean, it's not the longest cooldown ever. And he's going to have Talisman pretty soon, actually, so maybe he'll get to go back and get that. Not before Baron, but in the near future.
Double lens this game, upgraded, so they have that little bit extra control. And I like the Aegis as well, the locket for the poke damage. Very nice buy.
Yeah, Pilot has that QSS2 just in case he gets hit with a stun, Equilibrium Strike, or Xerath stun, or something like that.
Lots of weirdly placed wards, though, from Incredible Miracle. It's going to be hard to clear out every single one.
Yep.
GBM taking a chunk right there. GBM not going for an Abyssal this game, so playing a little bit more risky.
Yeah, went for the damage rather than the quote-unquote tankiness that the MR gives you against a champion like Xerath.
Oh, I can't see that ward in the back of the pit. There we go.
Aha. Uh-huh. Baron's like, yeah, please. It was messing with my feng shui in the pit.
All right, there's the blackout. We're going to detect that.
All right, so Baron activated by Jhenair. I am. This is their big chance. They're going to go in, though. Flash of Fusa already. Flash over the wall from Chaser. He's going to get kicked back by Ares. Oh, here comes the ult, though. Look out, XD. He's going to dodge it. Oh, but the execute comes in for Ares. He's going to pay for it. Beautiful equalizer from Trace. Meanwhile, Lilac's still chasing. They're going to push Jhenair away for the moment.
Jhenair should have stopped doing that Baron immediately upon
seeing
that engage was coming in, because there was some really brutal poke delivered by Frozen.
Yep.
And they can't survive those extended engages. They have to play around the Fog of War. Are they actually going to go for this Baron right now? They don't have a jungler.
The desperation is there, but I think that would be a little bit foolish. Aha, there we go. Iron Elixir onto Chaser. Now he's huge. That will surely do the trick.
He's large and ready to be in charge. Pilot's going to smash his face into a wall.
Yep. Why not? Because it's a quick draw. It's not actually supposed to be a dash, right? They're going to activate this Baron again. They're like, all right, come at me, bro. Equalizer not there, though. Trace is going to try to block the pit, and he's done this before. Baron getting at about half health now. Trace is blocking. Oh, there's a Zerasun. He's going to get poked really hard. Jhin'Air has to back away from this one. There's the engage, though. There's a disengage, though. Oh, Trace! Zonya's. He's going to be there, though. Now Jhin'Air. There's a nice Tibber stun. Flash from Trace. Will they be able to get away? And this is kind of what we're talking about with Jhin'Air. Things get a little bit silly sometimes in the late game.
Well, they have to. It's really hard for them to deal with this, to be fair. IM is playing this really well, and poke compositions are a pain in the ass. Now, they should have waited for this minion wave to hit before actually threatening the Baron seriously. Lilac is going to go try and deal with that, but he has teleport up, so it's just Jhin'Air needs to get a pick off, and they need to make sure they clear these wards. Really what Jhin'Air needs to do is just buy more pink wards. This is getting silly. Everybody needs a pink ward down right now. If everybody buys pink wards, they can easily take this.
Well, let's see what they do. They're all going back right now. GBM pushing up mid lane, but he'll probably recall after that. Warmog's finished for Chaser now, and he does pick up a pink ward.
But everybody needs pink.
There we go. XD has one. Pink Ward Watch 2015. So far, 2 out of 5. That is where it will remain, it looks like. Unless GBM sells his Doran's Ring.
Please
but no.
Sell your Doran's Ring, GBM.
No, it's 38 minutes into the game. That Doran's Ring is providing health and other benefits. Oh, he will sell it, though.
No, he bought a Spectral Cowl,
right.
That's okay.
All right.
It is the poke that's causing them harm in this situation.
True. Better than keeping the ring anyway.
That is undoubtedly true.
True facts. And will this red buff be taken? Trying to deny that vision with the smoke screen. Oh, I think that was taken by Ares.
Yep.
Able to actually just take that. Okay, so back to trying to control this Baron, although Dragon now up in about 45 seconds, and a fourth one would be pretty nice for Jhin'Air.
Oh, that's how they have to close this game.
Yeah.
In the end, this poke from Incredible Miracle is very annoying. IM is getting good wards down, and Jhin'Air doesn't have quite enough pink wards in order to deal with it. They're going to try again. Chaser already setting up on the side. They have this great vision control around Dragon. They can see if IM is going to try and trade the Dragon for a Baron and just run at them. Lots of pings going down on the map right now as Jhin'Air wants to clear out this final wave before the Dragon spawns.
They will. Back into the enemy jungle. They'll be spotted by a ward from IM, but IM kind of already knows what's up with that.
Well, they're really worried about trading this.
Oh, yeah, I think they might have to be.
Okay,
well, can they stop IM from taking this? Pilot just going for that Dragon himself, so that means he's not going to be there for the Baron fight. Jhin'Air? They scared them away anyway. Now
that's
Jhin'Air
how you do
the
it.
Disengage. Yep, yeah. You just threaten enough.
Yeah, have your AD just go ahead and solo it right there. If there's a fight that breaks out, you have enough poke damage with the Equalizer just to get them off the objective if absolutely necessary, and have your AD clean up later on. So
you
that's
can
Dragon
disengage.
Number 4.
It's very good.
Still really bad siege.
Well,
from Jhin'Air, that's not going to change anything. I am easily able to defend their base, and
well, there's really no fixing the siege for Jhin'Air. That's
nope.
That's a team comp thing. But I mean, when you pick this kind of comp, you kind of know this is going to happen,
yes,
right?
Yes,
and they've
absolutely.
They've certainly gotten the lead they need to close this out. They're 10,000
gold
ahead.
They're not overplaying these sieges at all. They're seeing what little kind of damage they can get in if they're going to be given an opportunity to freely auto attack, and they're playing it properly. They're just playing around Baron and Dragon repeatedly.
Yeah. I mean, when you do that, too, you can do one of two things. You can either get Baron or Dragon, or you can draw them out and then win a team fight, which is what you're perfectly happy doing, too. So
but you have to get a pick. That's
the
thing. You have to get a pick if you want to start taking down turrets at this point in the game. And their only hope is to try and poke them off of objectives and pray that there's going to be enough follow-up. But I think the poking will happen. The follow-up is what I'm concerned about. They're just...
Right.
Irelia is not in the best position.
Well, here we go. Irelia has that teleport available, but not really a lot of wards to go in on. Jhin'Air playing this Baron out very cautiously. XD and Trace, they did get that Baron. Will they turn around and get any kills out of this now? Nope, I am already on the run.
Lilac recalled, but they just did the Baron too fast in this late stage of the game.
Yeah. And this is why Jhin'Air can be so patient, because they're going to find these opportunities. And now, even though their siege isn't good, with the Baron-powered minions, they're going to be able to start chipping away at that turret.
I like seeing Jhin'Air do this, though, because it really is a new kind of look for them. They've been the poking team for most of this season, and to have such an all-in composition like we're seeing right now is something that's only really developed in the past couple weeks of watching them play. But one assumes that they are going to be closing out this game with this large lead that they have. And as they do, they're going to go on a four-game win streak, just like SK Telecom. So
pretty impressive. Oh, Chaser getting very close to being caught, manages to barely make it out as his team takes down that turret in top lane. But got to be careful. You don't want to get picked there.
He has to threaten, though. Otherwise, Grace can't get close enough in order to actually kill the turret.
Sounds like the next jungle camp monster to be invented, right? Should be. A little bit of damage on the pilot.
But the four-game win streaks that we see from both Jhin'Air and SKT, that's why this Saturday is going to be so fun when those teams hit each other, because both teams have been playing really, really well as of late. As CJ has fallen off, it looks like we pretty much have a definitive top three in terms of Jhin'Air, SKT, and GE.
I agree. Should be a very, very good match on Saturday. And Jhin'Air, you know, will take third place in the standings with a win here today.
Pretty convincingly as well.
Yep, big point spread. Jacer thinking about coming in. Oh, and they're going to pop that Righteous Glory. There we go. Use Talisman first. So both of those speed cooldowns on cooldown for XT.
Yeah, Ares really having a tough game right here.
Yeah.
Got picked a lot early, but it's really hard to stay alive against what Jhin'Air is throwing at you if you have to be contesting these objectives as Lee Sin, and at least trying to go in.
That's right. A little bit of a slow from Xerath, and a little bit of damage on that turret. Pilot really kind of running the edge there.
Yeah, it's really, really hard for Pilot to do anything right here.
Yeah. All right. Another Baron-powered wave coming through, and this is what they need to do, just slowly chip away at it. And it looks like, what a cue from Frozen, man.
Yeah, they have to just get out right there. The threat of the engage is too great at 50%, and they really don't want to be dying right now. They want to set up for this dragon. They have to push out that top wave. IAM's defense has been impressive this game.
Oh, never mind, they're going in. Tibbers comes down. Big Cataclysm, XD on the back line. Chaser gets pushed back into Tucson. Kill comes in for Graves. Frozen is down, and Jhin'Air should be able to pick this one up on Lilac as well. A kill for GBM, make it a double. And now I've got a feeling that bot lane might fall with only Sansar and Tucson up.
Great turnaround right there. They really baited IAM into that. They
had
the Righteous Glory and the Talisman to get on top of IAM immediately.
Yeah, IAM is fine.
To make those kills.
IAM is fine behind that turret, but if Jhin'Air can pull them out, the team fight is very, very strong with that huge pick potential.
Yeah, and you don't need HP if you just blow up their entire team immediately.
Looks like
they have a chance to hit you.
That's going to be the game. The death timer is just way too long right now. 7-0-4, the score for both the AD carry and the support. Oh, never mind. Pilot takes the lead and kills 8-0-4. Now Chaser trying to zone out Juice, and he wants a last bloodthirsty jungle kill. But Pilot, just going to turn around and end it. There we go. So Jhin'Air takes a very convincing 2-0. That's a four-match win streak now, and they will move into third place. GG.
Yeah, really well done by Jhin'Air.
Yeah, really well played. And again, you know, we talked today coming into it, that little bit of weakness in the later mid-game where they kind of make those little awkward decisions that didn't really seem to exist as much today as it did in other weeks. It was fairly clean.
Yeah, it was. I'm really looking forward to the SKG Jhin'Air match.
Yeah. I credit all to my bow tie choice today. There it is, the Doha winning bow tie.
The spaceships.
That's right, the spaceships. Not the, like,
also known as
like,
Houndstooth.
Houndstooth. I
was more commonly known as Houndstooth, sometimes known as Space Invader.
I was going to call it like Dragon Claw because I couldn't remember what you called it earlier, and I just need to think of a more awesome name than Houndstooth.
Houndstooth is a pretty good name.
Yeah, it's a good name for like a bar, but
it is not a good name for a bar.
Yeah, but it's not like a